In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good morning to you, dear brothers and sisters. Today, 12th May 2021, Wednesday in the 6th week of Easter. The first reading for the Holy Mass is taken from the Book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 17, verses 15, 22, to chapter 18, verse 1. And the Gospel is taken from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 16, verses 12 to 15. Jesus said to his disciples, "I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. But when he comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. He will not speak on his own, but he will speak what he hears and will declare to you the things that are coming. He will glorify me because he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. Everything that the Father has is mine. For this reason I told you that he will take from what is mine and declare it to you." Are you hungry for truth? Jesus proclaimed that he is the truth, the way, and the life. Truth is not something we create, nor is it our discovery. It is the gift of God, who is the possessor and giver of all truth. Jesus tells his disciples that it is the role of the Holy Spirit to reveal what is true, right, and good. Jesus told his disciples that the truth will set them free. The truth frees us from whatever is false, misleading, doubtful, or deceptive. In God there is no lie or falsehood, since he is utterly true, good, and just. Jesus told his disciples that he would send them the Spirit of truth, who will guide them into all the truth. Jesus knew that his disciples could not fully understand on their own everything he had taught and revealed to them while he was physically present with them. He knew that they would need the ongoing guidance and help of the Holy Spirit after he returned to his Father in heaven. That's why he assured them that the Holy Spirit would take what he had spoken to them and guide them into a fuller understanding of God's wisdom, power, and glory. Today, through the guidance of the Holy Spirit, we too proclaim the same ancient faith which the apostles taught, that Jesus died and was buried and rose again on the third day, and he will come again to judge, raise the dead, and give everlasting life. We not only share the same faith which was given to the apostles, but we also have the same Holy Spirit who raised Jesus from the dead. The Lord Jesus gives each of us his Holy Spirit as our divine teacher and helper, that we may grow in the knowledge, wisdom, and strength of God. Do you listen attentively to God's word and allow his Holy Spirit to give you an understanding of God's truth and plan for your life? Lord Jesus, fill me with your Holy Spirit and guide me in your way of life, truth, and goodness. Free me from ignorance of your truth and from deception and moral blindness caused by sinful pride and refusal to believe and obey your word of truth. May I love you with all my heart, mind, and strength, and seek to please you in all things. May Almighty God bless you, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.